Prince Ivan was all confused. What was that she had said? He had been so dizzy watching her, he had hardly realized what she was saying. The feather was a strange one. Beautiful, he must admit. But had she not mentioned something about danger? And the feather helping him? Seems a bit silly, thought the prince. I mean, what good is a feather if a wild beast jumps out at me? I can't hold out a feather and pretend it's a sword, can I? It was nice of the Firebird to give me this feather, but I can't see what use it is. And in any case, what kind of danger could there possibly be around here? It was at that moment that he looked up and stared. He had never seen that castle before. It looked horrible, dark and gloomy, with very narrow slits instead of windows, and a strange green light coming from each tiny crack, which shone on a collection of statues standing near the walls. Not ordinary statues. There was something strange about them. They were statues of people in positions of horror, running away from something, their hands up as if warding off some evil, their mouths open, their eyes terror-stricken. Prince Ivan tightened his grip on the feather because, as he watched, the door of the castle swung open and he saw figures coming towards him down the path. At first, Prince Ivan, who between you and me was not all that brave, hid behind a tree. But he soon realized that the figures coming towards him were girls, 9 of them. From where he was standing, it was quite obvious each was a princess. Princes in stories always know. Each princess was very beautiful. Prince Ivan stepped out from his tree and said, "Hello," to the first princess, who looked at him, put her hand up to her eyes and said, "Oh, no," and moved on. A bit rude, thought Prince Ivan, and tried again. "Hello," he said to the next princess, who shuddered and said, "Oh, no, not another," and walked away crestfallen. Extraordinary, thought the prince, hardly the way I'm usually greeted. "Good day," he greeted the third. "Do tell me who you are." "Oh, dear," exclaimed the third, "how sad. Speak to our head princess, the one at the end of the line." "How sad," she repeated, and walked away. Strange reactions, thought Prince Ivan, and waited for the last princess to approach. As you would expect, she was far more beautiful than all the others, a fact immediately noted by Prince Ivan, who, although not very good at finding his way in the forest, was pretty quick at recognizing a beautiful girl. "Hello," he said. "My name is Prince Ivan. Who are you?" The princess looked up at him, and her beautiful eyes grew sad when she saw such a handsome young man before her. "My name is Princess Tsarevna, and these princesses are my friends. Do leave at once." "That's not a very polite welcome, is it?" answered the prince. "I mean, hello, I am Tsarevna, do go. Doesn't seem to be very good manners for a princess of royal blood." "You don't understand," said Tsarevna. "My friends and I are prisoners of the wizard Caschet. He keeps us in that castle where he lives with lots of devils and demons and goblins." "So what's a wizard to me?" said Ivan. "I'm brave, I'll rescue you." He sounded braver than he felt. "No," said Tsarevna. "You see, Caschet is fearful, horrible. You must go at once, please." "I'm not afraid," said the prince, holding on to the feather. "But he's got green fingernails," announced the princess. "Then he should scrub them," said Prince Ivan. "Oh, please, Ivan, listen. Those green fingernails are deadly. If they touch you, you turn into stone." "Oh, please, Ivan, do go." She appealed to him. "Please, Ivan, go." "Look," she pointed to the castle. "See those statues? They were all people who came here like you. Caschet caught them, touched them, and now they stand there as statues forever. Oh, please, Ivan, save yourself whilst there's still time. Soon it will be dark, and Castier will be out with his friends. She implored the prince with such a look that he was tempted to do as she asked. No, he said, I'm not afraid. It's about time someone got rid of this Castier fellow for you. I'll try. Too bad, sighed the princess. It's nearly dark. And we have to be in before sunset. The nine princesses turned round and slowly climbed the hill up to the castle. The sun began to set, and the sky grew dark. Inside the castle, the green light grew stronger and stronger.